I don't understand why we don't look to other countries in the world for examples of how they handle issues like violent crime. I mean, you know, I think one of the things is that, you know, I used to spend a lot of time going in and out and visiting a hospital in Stockholm, Sweden, and recognize that, you know, their justice system is a little bit, is entirely different than ours. I mean, you know, if a person commits murder over there, you know, the longest sentence you're going to get is 10 years, but they put your butt in prison. They don't put your butt in a, you know, a daycare center. They put your butt in prison. I mean, I often say that, I used to say this all the time, is that why don't we build prisons in northern Alaska in the tundra? You know what I mean? And when you go to prison, you go to prison. And then I will give you 4 or 5 years or whatever it takes in a institution down here in the lower 40, 49, that will rehabilitate you before we allow you back in society. Why don't we spend more effort in rehabilitation than we do in just incarceration? And the incarceration, the way we spend money on that is, you know, building gyms and other things like that. Why don't we even look to and try to see if we can get advice from other countries?
I think that's a great point. And we're very much lagging behind the rest of the world in this. You know, we're the only Western country that still has things like the death penalty at all. The rest of the world moved on from this decades ago. We're continuing to ignore the science on trauma. We're continuing to ignore the mental health factors. We're continuing to ignore the public health factors around addiction and some of the other drivers of criminality. And again, we're certainly not focused on rehabilitation. I think it's really embarrassing. I think this is something that, you know, we sit here and 2020 and say, how did people let this happen? You know, how did they let slavery happen? How did they let the Holocaust happen? I think in 100 years, people are going to look back and say, how did you guys let this happen? How did you allow jails to look like this, prisons to look like this, for people to be treated this way? The problem underlying all of this is that we don't have a society that truly values human life. We have a society that sees human life as disposable. And I think that that is an ethics problem that we have to address in our mentality. I don't think that people lose their humanity, lose their worth because they've done something wrong. I think that we should find ways to hold them accountable for that wrongdoing and provide pathways for them to make restitution and to build ways that they can try to give back in spite of it and move forward and become productive and whole people again. That's our job as a society, I think, and we're really, really failing in that aspect.